I hear Ted. Well, must be going up to the garage. And what else? But I enjoyed the way it was done. And another scene that I really enjoyed was the all the money stuff. When basically the money was rolling in, it reminded me of the scene in Evita when Evita Peron's in the movie version, when her charities were bringing money in hand over fist, and it was called, I think the song is called, you know, The Money Keeps Rolling In, something like that. So that's what I was thinking of. And those bill counting machines in that scene, we had a machine like that in my bookstore out west. And when we had our book rush in September, the student, you know, textbook purchases, I mean, we used those bill counters like you wouldn't believe, because we would have so much money coming in. We had to have a bill counter eventually. So I could remember that. That was quite familiar to me. And what else? I also thought the scene where I can't remember the actor's name, but he was the one who didn't speak English and was going to put the bomb under, I guess, either a politician or television personality or whatever, somebody who was raising concerns about all of this drug trade, going to put a bomb in, under his car, and he did. And then Tony Montana had to, and his minions had to drive him around. It's because he didn't speak English. And then the intended target picked up his wife and two kids, and Montana wouldn't have anything to do with that, basically, in that scene, and killed the fellow. And I thought that was a very redemptive facet of his devolution, I suppose, you know, into complete debauchery. But it was part of the good part of him, because he wouldn't have anything to do with that. So he had to kill somebody to stop it, to stop him from killing somebody. Anyway. But man alive, you know, the homoerotic elements between Tony and his best friend, and then he kills him, and then, you know, his sister's basically like a Shakespearean figure, and like a, because he kills him because he's with his sister, so then it's not just Shakespearean, it's also like some kind of Greek tragedy, you know. So all of that went on, and then that went along like in a 5-minute clip, and then his sister was dead, and then, you know, 5 minutes later Tony was dead, and it was all actually kind of operatic, but not in the way that the Al Pacino character was in The Godfather with the... In, I guess it was it Godfather 1, or Godfather 2? Godfather 1, when he was killing the enemies while the baptism was going on of his first son. I think something like that. And then in Godfather 3, there was the actual opera. You know, when one of the sons was killed, or one of the kids was killed, and all of that. So, but not quite that way that De Coppola did it. But still operatic in a more Tarantino-esque way, I would say. But certainly excellent use of pyrotechnics and camera movement. And seeing how tackily the house was decorated, I was thinking that maybe it was actually somebody's real house and wanted to have it demolished, like the way in Gone with the Wind, the burning of Atlanta was actually the studio burning excess sets, things that they didn't need anymore, or something like that. Or there was some kind of land development was going to happen, I forget. But anyway, this to me looked like somebody was just destroying a real house, you know, to make room for something else. Anyway, music was by Giorgio Moroder, who was responsible in large part for my favorite disco music of the 70s and 80s, which was the Donna Summer music and other performers. I also think he did the music for that movie where Brad Davis was in Turkish prison, and a 1978 movie I remember was out, and I can't remember the name, Midnight Express, yeah. I remember selling the book. It was very popular. I never saw the movie, Midnight Express. And I like his music a lot. I really like his use of electronic instruments and drums and whatever, percussive instruments. The script was by Brian De Palma. Stone, Oliver Stone. It looked more like it was a movie directed by Oliver Stone, as far as that goes. And I like Oliver Stone movies. So I think that's about all I've got to say. It certainly is over the top, but I can understand why it's like a cult favorite in temperament, but a huge popular movie as far as DVDs and CD, Blu-rays, and reissues, and film festivals and things like that, because it really did have a lot of style, and I could see that people would like to see it often because there's always something new to see, you know. I did want to say another thing about one of the actors that was dispatched pretty quickly, F. Murray Abraham, who was hanged from a helicopter. I thought that was actually quite a good stunt, quite a good scene. And he is so versatile. I think he's supposed to be kind of full of himself, like Ben Kingsley is, but you know, they are Oscar winners, and some people do let it go to their heads, perhaps. But he was Salieri in Amadeus, if you didn't place him in this. And also, he was in the famous early 1970s a gay movie based on the play called The Boys in the Band. And his famous scene, if you want to look it up on the net, is where he comes into the party, because it's based on a stage play, so it's very stagey, so to speak. And he comes in and he's late to the party, and he says, and somebody's complaining that he's late to the party, and he says, "I'm a 35-year-old self-hating Jew," or something to that effect, and ugly Jew, and if it takes me, you know, such and such a length of time to get myself together, so be it. And you really should look that up, because it's a wonderful, wonderful scene and a wonderful acidic queenie delivery that I really recommend, because it's extremely well done. So that's F. Murray Abraham in The Boys in the Band, so you can find that on the net. Anyway, come to me for a little bit of history. Anyway, I've gone on a long time, and I've enjoyed the movie immensely, and I would like to get some video responses to this so that you can enter my contest. Video entries to any of my 29 movies. So, today was Scarface, and tomorrow is another very, very popular movie, and I have never seen this one, Office Space, so some people are really looking forward to hearing what I've got to say about it. And are concerned that I won't like it because they like it so much. Anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, this was Our Daily FEBs number 10, tomorrow's number 11, and I will see you around the tube.